And we are live. Wonderful. Let's just wait a little bit for our viewers, our lovely viewers to join in. Hi Karan. Hello Navneet. Oh, nice. Nice to see a steady stream of people waiting to listen to our interview series today. Welcome everyone. Today we have the interview series of the Goa Jazz Academy's Your Sunday Soundtracks Volume 8. So now, for the past 2 months, you get gotten used to it that every Sunday the Goa Jazz Academy puts out a playlist. We at the Academy believe that even though not everyone considers themselves a musician per se, everyone enjoys to listen to music. And we thought, why not put together playlists so that we can all have this common thing that we all listen to and discuss and celebrate every weekend, every Sunday, and hence the idea of the Goa Jazz Academy's Your Sunday Soundtracks was born. And for the past 2 months, we've had different musicians, really established and trusted people in the industry who have taken out the time and very generously put together playlists for us week after week. So we've had playlists from Nikhil Mokin, from Lucia, from our founder Karan, our faculty said, and a bunch of other musicians and also people from other walks of life who have a great taste in music and who can educate us a little bit about this different kind of music that day that we should all check out. So today we have someone very special joining us all the way from New Delhi. His name is Abhay Sharma, saxophone player from New Delhi, founder and band leader of the Revisit Project. He's an active session musician and equally adept at the jazz EDM, but he's also an active session player in Bollywood. He's played with Shankaresan Loy, Vishal Bhadwaj, Rekha Bhadwaj, Arnan Sami for the past half a decade, so to say. So we are really looking forward to have him on board. Let's quickly get him on the chat and we roll.
Can you see me?
Yes, Abhay. We can see you. We can hear you. Am I audible, visible?
You hear me? Absolutely. You are audible and visible. Am I audible properly?
Yes.
Connected.
Yes, you are.
Properly.
Yes, you are.
Perfect. Hi, man.
Perfect.
What's up?
I'm great. How are you?
I'm good, yeah. I was waiting for the session since the morning because I haven't made a playlist in 10 days. I usually make a lot of playlists in my personal life for my friends and for other people as well. And yeah, this playlist is really special also because, it was you and you, like we spoke about it today, that we were both in Delhi during the golden period of Delhi music scene from 2012, 13 onwards till about 16, which is when a lot of, I mean, there was a lot of young kids coming up and young cats, if I can call them.
Us included.
I mean, you can include us as well. Abhay, Prince of Funk. Okay. Thanks. Prince of Funk,
so,
I don't know.
So we've been listening to this playlist at the Academy last night and even during the afternoon today. And it's a fantastic listen. It's 1 hour and 45 minutes, but it has such tasteful music that we didn't realize the passage of time. So thank you very much for putting together such a tasteful playlist for us.
Do you guys do collective listening? Is that what you're doing? Or do you individually
listen? There's music always playing at the Academy. So we do listen to your playlist all together and we really enjoyed it. What I wanted to ask you about was since you know you've been playing music for a while and when it came to putting together a playlist like this, how was your experience in general? Like you might have had to omit certain tunes or add certain tunes that, you know, I must have this artist on. So was it a difficult process to put together a playlist that kind of encompasses all your influences over the years? How was the process like for you?
You know what? Like whenever I'm making playlists about music, it is very difficult to choose because musicians change over a period of time, right? Like every month, because you're practicing, you're playing, and you're around musicians. But unfortunately, that's not happening right now. But nonetheless, we as human beings grow, right? So sometimes you grow out of a particular vibe. Sometimes, like there is recreational music listening for musicians. And then there's educational music listening. You know what I mean? Like, for example, I've seen other jazz musicians also do this where you will be listening to just the 50s or the 40s or the 60s or the 70s or just one composer or just one discography or just one guitar player or just one saxophone player or just one Hindustani classical musician or probably just a film composer, just his entire discography. Catalog of music. But this playlist particularly, I wanted songs which just had an instant effect on me. And they almost all of them come from the how do I say this, the middle of the bat. And if the middle of the bat, like when the ball hits the middle of the bat, right, it just goes straight for a four. And the middle of the bat for me would be blues, funk, R&B, soul, gospel, and a bit of jazz influence because jazz comes from all of these and then encapsulates that experience and then puts forth something new almost decade after decade. And so these are all songs that yeah have had an instant effect on me because when I'm listening to the song for the first time, any song, I don't care about the genre, I really want to listen to it as a fan. मैं तब उसको analyze नहीं करता कि ये कहाँ चेंज कहाँ जा रहा है, ये ट्राइटोन क्यों उन्होंने सब्स्टिट्यूट किया या जो भी. आई एम जस्ट सेइंग, आई एम जस्ट ऑफ द टॉप ऑफ माय हेड, आई एम जस्ट सेइंग कि क्यों नहीं सी के बाद डी फ्लैट सेवन क्यों नहीं लगा या उसमें G7 क्यों लगे,
यू
ये
लिसन
इतना
फॉर
सब
सेक
मैं
ऑफ
सोच.
लिसनिंग.
आई डोंट डू दैट व्हेन आई एम लिसनिंग टू द सॉन्ग फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम, और बिकॉज इट हैज टू जस्ट लिटरली, फॉर मी म्यूजिक इज लिटरली अबाउट स्टोरी टेलिंग स्ट्रेट अप. And wait, the message has to come through in whatever form. It's almost like you're all of us are like ice cream sellers, and jazz is a taste, and funk is a taste, and R&B is a taste, and वो तो अपन लोग का काम है अच्छा संडे बना के देना. And that's what I believe. So that's what this playlist is also. It starts with Christopher Cross का music, goes through Stevie Wonder, and then yeah, go on talk about it since you also
Yeah, I
hear it.
mean it's a great assemblage of tunes. There's Stevie Wonder, there's Christopher Cross, Herbie Hancock, of course. I'm a big fan and I was glad that you are
Yeah,
too. Star of Power.
absolutely.
There's also some traditional jazz thrown in. There's Wes Montgomery, there's Zoot Sims,
Yeah.
Hank Mobley, but also some like some Allman Brothers, Tedeschi Trucks
All
Band. So
blues for sure, for sure.
it's a great collection of tunes that it's I would like to put it this way that it's easy to listen to even as a passive listener, but if you want to find the musicality, if you are listening as with musicians' ears, there's still plenty to go. And yes, Karan mentioned two tunes by Toto. Sorry, I forgot. Both
Absolutely.
of them. You finished with Rosanna, which is one of my
Yeah.
favorites.
Just
Super.
the drum fill only. Jeff Porcaro.
Yes, certainly. So, Abhay, you mentioned that you picked songs that had an instant effect on you, and I feel the same way about a few of these tunes. I would like to just gloss over a couple of tunes that from this playlist that
Sure.
really made an impression on you.
Go ahead.
You can pick any tune from your playlist that that affected you, that you still remember the first time that you listened to them, something that profound.
You know, for me, there's this tune which there's a song called 4 AM by Herbie Hancock.
Jaco on the bass,
And
of
yeah,
course.
it's got Jaco on bass. I don't know who's playing drums. Is it Harvey Mason? I don't know. I
It's
don't know who is it.
Harvey Mason.
It's Harvey Mason. So that song, right? For me personally as a listener, क्योंकि अपन लोग का सीन क्या है, मैं ना आई कम फ्रॉम अ वेरी डिसेंट लाइक मिडिल क्लास फैमिली फ्रॉम नॉर्थ दिल्ली, तो अपन लोग के लिए ना अपब्रिंगिंग बड़ा डिफरेंट है. इट्स वेरी डिफरेंट फ्रॉम समवन हु विल बी स्टेइंग इन न्यूयॉर्क और पेरिस और समवन एल्स. सो फॉर मी वेस्टर्न म्यूजिक रियली हिट अस व्हेन आई वाज 8, 9 with Backstreet Boys and all of these other things happening in my life.
Mm-hmm.
But the real, like when I was moved and I just could not go back, like it was just a gateway that opened and now the doors cannot be shut, was when I heard Jaco play, what was it? I think it was Black Market ka jo gana hai, Babri Ghost. And then I, so for me, music is before Jaco and then post Jaco. Like I was 17, I remember clearly. Someone suggested that, you know what, since you're into Western music, why don't you listen to Weather Report? I was like, I don't, Weather Report kya naam hua band ka? And then he's like, usme usme wo hai apna जो जावेनुल है, जो कैरनबॉल के लिए बजाता था, एंड सो दैट जस्ट शुक मी कंप्लीटली, दैट वन मूव, एंड देन आई जस्ट वेंट ऑन एंड ऑन सर्चिंग फॉर हिम. सो दिस 4 AM, जस्ट जस्ट द स्टार्ट ऑफ द सॉन्ग, दु 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 दु. सो इट्स लाइक जस्ट सच क्लासिक जाको, एंड दिस इज लाइक मी सर्चिंग फॉर जाको, व्हाट ऑल एल्बम्स हैज जाको प्लेड ऑन. एंड right when I was discovering Jaco, I got into Herbie Hancock, and it is a match made in heaven. These guys, I mean, how do I say this? It's like they wrote the syllabus for the next 1,000 years. You know what I mean? Because it's just the combination of Jaco and Herbie Hancock on this song, and then there's a solo. Herbie Hancock plays a solo. Oof. When the entry of the solo. There's a chromatic and oof, how I think it's just these three people, Jaco, Harvey Mason, and Herbs, Herbie Hancock,
Hancock.
and oof, that, so that is just like, I still can't believe this song happened, but yeah, go on.
And it's such a galaxy of sounds, right? Just see people.
Oof.
You know, just this platter of sounds that you're just drowned in, and even like after close to 50 years of that song being recorded, we still find it just as fresh as the first
And
time we
you know
heard.
what, like now since I get to record myself almost every second, third day, I record myself and I feel great about it. But now when I look back and I'm trying to see that these guys must have gotten into the studio, what, once a month or 2 months, right? And the like, you rarely had to be very, very fortunate to be in a position to go ahead and record yourself. So imagine now it's fairly simple for us to say record karke bhej de part. It's like these three people just got into the studio. Obviously they're the greatest musicians of in the world at that point in time as well. But I'm just saying that I cannot believe what some of these people have done on the record. Same for I think same for all of these people. Like all I'm you know what, मेरे चेहरे पे एक खुशी आ जाती है when I talk about these people.
That's exactly what I'm talking about. Because then I was listening to this playlist, I was probably smiling the same way that I heard the song for the first time, and I think that would have been the same way that you smiled on the first time. And if
Oof.
you took to listen to it 10 days hence, 10 years hence, it would be the same. That's the beauty of music.
And the best part about great music, I believe that there is great music. A lot of people say that there is, okay, there is, every music is great and this and that. But for me personally, I think there is this denser form of music, which doesn't have to be complex. It's just dense. It's information condensed in a way that it reveals itself after years and years. Same for, it happens with Rehman as well in India. It happens with Zakir Ji as well. It happens with Panchanda as well in India. It happens with Madan Mohan as well. But when you talk about arrangement and just the emphasis of each and every note, you have to hear some of these jazz musicians and just it's mind blowing. Same for Actual Proof. I'd say all of the Herbie Hancock songs, even Hang Up Your Hang-Ups, oof. Like this is the syncopation. It's just it. I don't know. I just get super excited about. Then talking about some of the other songs in the on the playlist, there's this Lowdown करके Boz Scaggs का जो गाना है. Now, so that is the epitome of songwriting for me. Boz Scaggs. There are these people who all of us, like since I'm also from Delhi, very like North Delhi, कुछ ज़्यादा पता नहीं म्यूजिक के बारे में. Discovering some of these people like माइकल मैकडॉनल्ड, बेसिकली डूबी ब्रदर्स वाला जो बैंड है, देन ऑलमन ब्रदर्स, दैट होल सदर्न रॉक बेल्ट, एंड जस्ट सीइंग हाउ डू दिस, एंड देन ये तो फिर भी इतना सदर्न रॉक नहीं है, बट इसमें जेफ पोरकारो ने प्ले किया है, एंड देन द होल एलए म्यूजिशियंस एंड न्यूयॉर्क म्यूजिशियंस एंड बॉस कैग्स हो गया, माइकल मैकडॉनल्ड हो गया, डोनाल्ड फेगन हो गया, ये जो लोग हैं जस्ट डिस्कवरिंग द म्यूजिक एंड जस्ट डिस्कवरिंग हाउ दे अप्रोच्ड सॉन्ग राइटिंग इज उफ, आई थिंक इट्स टू मच टू लाइक इवन कॉम्प्रिहेंड समटाइम्स. द आर्ट ऑफ सॉन्ग राइटिंग, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू लर्न, यू हैव टू लिसन टू स्टीली डैन, यू हैव टू लिसन टू डूबी ब्रदर्स, यू हैव टू लिसन टू ऑलमन ब्रदर्स, पार्लियामेंट फंकाडेलिक, इन टर्म्स ऑफ द काइंड ऑफ स्टफ दैट आई वॉन्ट टू डू, आई वॉन्ट टू राइट म्यूजिक इज वेल.
And
And
even to
all of this is important.
yeah, even to people who might not be playing an instrument per se, this is a nice playlist to just understand, like just appreciate how good music can be when just
Yeah,
people get together and
sure.
play. Some of it is just instrumental music, but it still speaks to you. Sometimes you feel that we need a language, but you know, when all language fails, this music.
But wait, I mean, I think even if you're not a musician, right? If music wala jo scene hai na, like it's very different in that sense, because this playlist particularly is in a way, how do I say it? It is approachable. It is not something that you'd say, yaar nahi, main na bada hoke sununga. Like some you avoid listening to some people, right, in life, because they're like, dude, I can't get into such dense music, or I can't get it. But it's not that. Like the playlist starts with Christopher Cross, I have it in front of me. Then it goes to a song that Brinda introduced me, the singer for the band. We're together as well. Baby Come Back करके गाना है. So she keeps like I discover music from other people and their playlists. And you know, then Boogie on Reggae Woman with Stevie Wonder. Stevie Wonder is, I think, the greatest songwriter of all time. Like his harmonic sense, I mean, lyrics, ठीक है, some of them do talk about his experience as an African American person there as well, and all of those other social issues as well. Lyrics are up there with probably James Taylor or Joni Mitchell or some of the other people. I should have added Joni Mitchell as well to this playlist. But yeah, there's another very underrated song in the playlist called "I Just Want to Stop," and it's by this guy called Gino Vanelli. अब उसका क्या सीन था, उस व्यक्ति का क्या सीन था, वो ना बेसिकली कनाडा से था इन लेट 60s, मिड 70s में, एंड उसने 2-3 साल ट्राई किया जैज करने का न्यूयॉर्क में या 2-3 और जगहों पे, बात नहीं बनी, फिर वो वापस चला गया कनाडा, एंड देन समवन सॉ हिम एंड मीन लाइक कि यार तू तो साला, तू गाता भी है, तू म्यूजिक भी करता है, यू नो देयर्स दिस न्यू सीन हैपनिंग वेयर न्यू सॉन्ग राइटर्स आर कमिंग इन, यू नो इट्स अ न्यू साउंड. तो तू सॉन्ग्स, व्हाई डोंट यू सिंग योर सॉन्ग्स एंड राइट देम एंड डू इट इन अ सॉर्ट ऑफ मॉडर्न कॉन्टेक्स्ट. एंड मोस्ट ऑफ दीज म्यूजिशियंस ऑन द प्लेलिस्ट, ऑन द सेट लिस्ट, द प्लेलिस्ट दैट आई हैव सेंट टू यू, हैव हैड सम सॉर्ट ऑफ म्यूजिकल बैकग्राउंड जिसमें उन्होंने थोड़ा सा सीखा है म्यूजिक, या जैज या फंक या ब्लूज से आते हैं. दैट्स ऑल्सो द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ दिस प्लेलिस्ट पर से.
Great, great, great. I'm sure people are going to have a ball when they listen to this over brunch tomorrow.
And even if you don't want to go deep, there's Tears for Fears and there's Johnny Hates Jazz. There's a band called Johnny Hates Jazz, जो कि बहुत बहुत ही एक सही बैंड है लंदन का. And yeah, you should check this out. Go on, what we ask.
Sure. So, Abhay, you since most of the playlist dabbles with the funk jazz and that kind of genre broadly. But you also are deeply influenced by Bollywood music, and you play sessions
Absolutely.
for Bollywood artists as well. So I just had an inquiry as to how different is it playing in a Bollywood context on stage versus playing as an indie musician in the independent music scene in
Sure,
India?
I'll just answer that. Someone's asked, what about Miles Davis? What about him? Yeah, he's again one of the greatest musicians of all time. Changed music forever. Changed the approach of jazz, like the train. He kind of guided it to like the modal stuff. मतलब बीबॉप से वो चार्ली पार्कर से लेते हुए रेस वाला बेटन बैटन जो भी बोलते हैं लिया, एंड टुक इट टू हिज एक्सट्रीम, देन गाइडिंग जॉन कोल्ट्रेन टू अ पोजिशन वेयर ही इज लाइक कि चल ठीक है, अब तेरे को लाइक वी वेंट थ्रू द मॉडल एरा, अब तू उसको हार्ड बॉप कर दे, एंड यू नो दैट So Miles Davis is again one of those giants, I'd say. And just the emphasis again, the emphasis on the spaces in music. Dude, we are not even well-equipped to sometimes answer things about Miles Davis. He is one of the greatest. But talking about the differences between playing Bollywood, यार एक तो मुझे ये टर्म ना थोड़ी थोड़ी प्रॉब्लम है, बट ठीक है, सब यूज करते हैं तो ठीक है, इसका हो गया सीन. आई थिंक हिंदी फिल्म म्यूजिक का प्रॉब्लम या सोल्यूशन यही है कि प्रॉब्लम मैं इसलिए बोल रहा हूँ बिकॉज वो एक इट्स अ प्रॉब्लम दैट अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल नॉट एबल टू सॉल्व एज म्यूजिशियंस. हाउ डू वी डील एज अ सेशन म्यूजिशियन विद द हिंदी फिल्म म्यूजिक, ये बड़ा मुश्किल सवाल है. और इसमें प्रॉब्लम ये है दैट हम सब ने ना उसकी इतनी बेइज्जती कर दी है अब दैट अब उसको रिकवर करना बड़ा मुश्किल है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, साइकोलॉजिकली आई प्रॉब्ली डिड नॉट कम फ्रॉम अ बैकग्राउंड जिसमें उसकी इतनी बेइज्जती की हो, बट हिंदी फिल्म म्यूजिक की भी एक हिस्ट्री है. वो हिस्ट्री क्या है मैं आपको जैसे फॉर एग्जाम्पल मच रिसेंट ट्रिल अबाउट मच रिसेंट SEL वर बिग, राइट? शंकर एहसान लॉय वर द थिंग, राइट? बट जस्ट अ फ्यू ईयर्स बिफोर शंकर एहसान लॉय देयर वाज जतिन ललित इन द 90s, एंड जतिन ललित आर प्राइमरली जस्ट आर डी बर्मन, पंचन दास म्यूजिक, आर डी बर्मन म्यूजिक रीडन. यू नो द अरेंजमेंट स्टाइल इज द सेम, द म्यूजिशियंस दैट दे यूज्ड वर द सेम म्यूजिशियंस पंचन दास यूज्ड. देन पंचन दास स्टाइल इज प्रीटी मच वेरी वेरी सिमिलर टू हिज ओन फादर ऑब्वियसली, बट ऑल्सो सलिल चौधरी, हेमंत कुमार एंड शंकर जयकिशन, विच इज द नाउ यू आर गेटिंग बैक फ्रॉम 80s 70s टू द 60s. देन दोज पीपल वर एक्चुअली लिसनिंग टू गाइज लाइक रविंद्रनाथ टैगोर म्यूजिक एंड पंकज मलिक. देन देर वॉज दीज टू कंपोजर्स कॉल्ड हुसन लाल भगत राम एंड अनिल बिस्वास. दीज आर पीपल हु स्टार्टेड हिंदी फिल्म म्यूजिक बैक इन 30s 20s 30s 40s. एंड सो इन दैट सेंस आई एम नॉट कॉलिंग देम आर्ट टेटम और एनीथिंग. आई एम जस्ट सेइंग देयर इज अ हिस्टोरिकल बैकग्राउंड कि ढोलक क्यों यूज होती है किसी तरीके के म्यूजिक में, ढोलक और ढोलक का क्या पर्पज है म्यूजिक का. दीज आर वेरी स्मॉल नुआंसेस जो अपन लोग को ना हम वी जस्ट ग्लॉस ओवर कि नहीं यार नहीं बजाना मैं जो सैक्सोफोन, यू नो आई एम सॉरी आई सेड दैट बट यार I mean, can I say all of these things here? But I don't know.
Let's
I
try to
abuse
say
quite a
as
lot.
little
I'm
as
sorry.
we can.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. So I abuse quite a lot. I'm sorry. I'm actually trying to get done with that. But I'm just saying,
But go on.
these things are very important to contextualize. कि ये चीजें आ कहाँ से रही. What is the use? Why were we using strings back in the 50s and 60s? What emotion did it serve? What purpose did it serve? You know? And getting that down to the T is what you must do first and foremost. It is not like आपने गुलाबी आंखें सीख लिया तो आपको बॉलीवुड आ गया या हिंदुस्तान हिंदी फिल्म म्यूजिक आ गया. दैट्स नॉट द केस. यू हैव टू रियली अंडरस्टैंड वेयर सम ऑफ दीज म्यूजिशियंस आर कमिंग फ्रॉम, बिकॉज यू विल गेट अ बॉलीवुड गिग समवेयर डाउन द लाइन इन लाइफ. बट देन द कैट्स ऑफ बॉम्बे they can see through the bullshit. If you do not know your Panchen Da, your Open Air, your SD Burman, your Salil Chaudhary, and because that is what all of us really like. If you end up listening to music with your mom and your father and your cousins, they're still singing Jeevan ke din chote sahi, you know, they're still singing those melodies or lag jaag le. So all of these melodies are like evergreen, right? And you have to know these melodies because music is just about that. It's about knowing enough songs. Sonny Rollins उठा लो, Herbie Hancock को उठा लो, दुनिया के जितने भी बड़े musicians हैं, they knew song after song after song, and they could say that. They could say it through their instrument, and that is what I'm saying. वो करना बड़ा जरूरी है when you contextualize playing in Bollywood and Bombay, right? Because a lot of people just बोरिया बिस्तरा उठाया और पहुंच गए बॉम्बे, विच विल हेल्प यू, देर इज अनफ वर्क देयर, बट टू रियली नो वेर इट्स कमिंग फ्रॉम, बिकॉज यू विल नॉट जस्ट मीट पीपल हु आर मेकिंग म्यूजिक फॉर एड्स और जिंगल्स और सम अदर शिट. you should be in a position where you can tell the color of the music. And I'm not saying actual color, I'm saying metaphorically, you should be able to say कि यार यहाँ ना ड्रम्स की शायद जरूरत नहीं है, यहाँ ढोलक. अब यूपी का कुछ कॉन्टेक्स्टुअल, लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ यू डूइंग बैकग्राउंड स्कोर फॉर समथिंग, दिस इज वाई पीपल लाइक अमित त्रिवेदी एंड स्नेहा खानवलकर बिकेम सुपर हिप बैक इन द अर्ली 2000s, बिकॉज दे न्यू कि जहाँ पर ढोलक और फोक म्यूजिक की रिक्वायरमेंट है वहाँ आप जैज और फंक से नहीं बात बना सकते. दैट इज द पर्पज. सो अंडरस्टैंडिंग द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ वॉट इज रिक्वायर्ड ऑफ ऑफ यू इज ऑल्सो रियली इम्पॉर्टेंट. तो येस, अंडरस्टैंड बॉलीवुड हिस्टोरिकली एंड यू जस्ट हैव टू डू अ बिट ऑफ रिसर्च, टॉक टू पीपल अराउंड एंड दैट दैट वर्क्स आउट इवेंचुअली.
ग्रेट ग्रेट, वो जरिया कहाँ से आया वो जरूरी है।
हाँ बिल्कुल बिल्कुल. ये चीज आई कहाँ से, ये बड़ा इंपॉर्टेंट. अदरवाइज आई टेल यू व्हाट हैपेंस, इफ यू डू नॉट नो द हिस्ट्री ऑफ वेयर यू आर कमिंग फ्रॉम ना, प्रॉब्लम ये होती है दैट 2 या 3 ईयर डाउन द लाइन देयर कम्स अ यंग और अ यंग सैक्सोफोन प्लेयर और अ यंग ड्रमर और अ यंग म्यूजिशियन हु नोज दैट, एंड फिर यू विल अनफॉर्चुनेटली बी रिप्लेस्ड बिकॉज इट्स अ वेरी कट थ्रोट सिटी एंड इट्स अ वेरी कट थ्रोट थ्रोट सीन. And you really, really we ha have to be on your toes all the time. That's why I unfortunately never really ventured out to move to Bombay because it's difficult. It's difficult to survive as a musician in Bombay because you may get work, but to earn the respect of the city, you have to be a cat. It's cat, you know. And
Well, thanks for sharing this so honestly. It really helps all of us put things in context and really open our eyes and ears
yeah.
to all the music that has such a rich heritage that sometimes we
It
overlook
does,
very
it
easily.
does. From Anil Biswas to unfortunately Himesh Lesania.
जो भी आने वाला
So,
है। तो
जो भी आना है.
अबे आगे बढ़ते हैं। Speak a little about Revisit Project, the band that you lead in. What's happening right now, and from inception till now, what have you been working on, and how has the
Yeah,
sound
right now
shaped?
we are working. We have a song coming out in July, and that's called Miles to Coltrane. It's a love song that I've written. It's about how metaphorically, like a couple is sharing its camaraderie, similar to what Miles and Coltrane did back in the 60s and 50s. And I mean, so that's happening. And then while we are doing that, we're also kind of reworking some of our old songs to suit the new kind of musical taste that we have. And the album is it in fact it ended today. Like we were like composing, we were arranging a song which was almost over now. So the new album, which will have what around 8, 9, I don't know, 9 or 10 songs, I don't know how many songs, but yeah, that's coming out soon in the next 4 or 5 months. We're actually waiting to record things, and yeah, that's happening. Quite a lot of things are happening. The only unfortunate bit is we're not playing the gigs that pay us or the gigs that help us survive either. Dono gigs nahi ho rahi hai. So yeah, that's quite a bummer, but practice ho rahi hai. All of us are practicing. I can
And
show
you're
you that.
still being creative and writing music and looking forward to sharing it, which serves as a great motivation to others in the musician community and the artist community at large. This is a time
Yeah, I mean,
to write
it's
afresh,
very difficult. But it's very difficult for a young musician, huh? If I think about, if I was a young 20, 21-year-old musician right now, it's scary, because one thing that I had when I was 21 is I could reach out to anyone at that point in time, and like literally physically be there. Like if someone called me for a meeting, it was not just based on my Instagram performance or YouTube performance. And that is something that's just gone beyond, it's gone off the rails, I must say. Like musicians are trying to do everything that they can now to impress each other and the people higher up in the order. And you know, people who've never sung Hindi are suddenly singing Hindi now. People who've never sung Western are suddenly singing Western, and it's just आई डोंट नो,
तो
इट्स
वो
अप
ऐसा भी हो
टू.
सकता है ना, सोचने का थोड़ा टाइम मिल गया कि ओके लेट्स मी ट्राई समथिंग न्यू.
अच्छा
सो
हाँ,
इट्स अ टाइम फॉर एक्सपेरिमेंटेशन फॉर एवरीवन एंड वी हैव टू बी
ट्रू
वेरी
ट्रू.
टू
एज
दैट
लॉन्ग एज द
ऑल्सो.
रिस्पेक्ट फॉर द म्यूजिक इज
सर्टेनली
देयर, एज लॉन्ग एज यू अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ द म्यूजिक, अनलेस इट्स इट शुडंट जस्ट बी कि काम मिल जाएगा तो हिंदी कर लेते हैं, यू नो, वो नहीं होना चाहिए. ये बहुत, ये एक है, मैं जानता हूँ, ये एक है कॉन्सेप्ट.
इट्स ओके लाइक दे हैव टू लिव इन इट एज लॉन्ग एज देयर
एब्सोल्युट
हैप्पी. ठीक
एब्सोल्युट या
है. So, Abhay, any parting words? Would you like to say something quickly about the playlist or message to our listeners who have so patiently heard you so long?
Nothing, just I hope that we all recover from this, and just don't worry, it's all good, like we'll figure this out, and even if we don't, someone else will, and then they'll help us figure this out, and yeah, just keep at it, keep learning, keep practicing, and bus, nothing much, man. I'm pretty positive about things, even though we've had quite a torrid few horrid Torrid bullying and horrid few weeks and months, like it was pretty bad, but I think now things are kind of recovering, and I hope we can get back to being in a position where we are playing gigs. I miss live gigs, man. That's it. That is the ultimate, that's the end game. ऐसे बोलते हैं, हाँ, you know what I mean.
Certainly. Well, Abhay, thank you so much for giving us your time and putting together this wonderful playlist that I'm sure people are going to enjoy a lot tomorrow. Hopefully, we'll associate more in your future and
Someone's
do more
asking
things.
something. When is your next concert?
Oh,
I
wow.
have no idea, man. We just canceled 3 gigs in July because of the fact that no, some of us do not have the first dose. So we are actually looking at a position where all of us have at least the first dose going for all of us, and then probably August onwards. Thanks, Karan sir, and August onwards is what I am looking at. Probably that'll be something that'll be good. Yeah, I mean August onwards, I think we can hope for resumption. September, October, September.
We hope so too, and we hope to see you live sometime very, very soon. Thanks so much, Abhay, for joining us. And thank you all our viewers for sticking till the very end. I just have a quick few things that I want to talk about the things happening at the Academy. We recently put out a beautiful newsletter for the month of June. If you'd like to subscribe to it, please leave your email ID. Please DM it to us, and we'll make sure that it reaches your inbox. We have a great course on modular synthesis starting tomorrow, and there are just a few seats available for that. So if that's something that interests you, making your new fresh sounds using signal chains and all of that stuff, do check us out. The link is in our bio. Next week for our playlist, we have a very special person coming in. He runs a channel called WTF Grooves on Instagram and YouTube, and he's a very cool guy. He transcribes movie dialogues and sounds that we can't really process as music per se, but then he shows us how that also is music. He's an incredibly he's on another level in terms of thinking about rhythm. So we are having him for a chat next Saturday, followed by a playlist by him on Sunday. And we're also finally launching a Foundation in Music program at GGA. It starts early August, and we're going to open the applications next week. So please stay tuned for that. If you know any musicians who would like to show off their musical skills, please share it with them when it comes out. Thanks again, Abed, for the
For
playlist
sure,
and for
man.
your time. And thank you all the viewers for sticking together. And we will see you next Saturday, 8 p.m. Until then, have a very good night. Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.